right? Now the force experienced by all electrons in this DL element, there is a particular volume, right? In this DL element, in this small volume, right, what is the force? That force is represented by df bar. Therefore df bar is equals to, what is f? F is equals to experienced by all electrons. Experienced by all electrons means the force on a single electron and number of electrons in a DL volume. What is F? That is E into, what to say, VD cross B bar cross V bar into number of electrons in a DL volume. Right? Number of electrons per unit volume, how much? N. Number of electrons in a DL volume. DL volume, what is the volume of the length element? DL, A into DL. Therefore, this is number of electrons in a DL volume, that is N into, right, N into A into, that is what you say, DL. Now, this may be written as DF bar is equals to, right, N E A V D, right, N, right, E, A, that is VD into, that is small length element, DL bar, that is B bar. Now, therefore, DF bar is equals to NEAVD. NEAVD is equals to, what to say, I. This is total represented by I into, what to say, that is DL bar cross B bar. Now, therefore, whatever the number of electrons present in a DL volume, such a small volume. Here first, the force experienced by single charge. The force experienced by the single charge. Now, the force experienced by electrons in a DL element. Now, therefore, the force experienced, the force experienced by all electrons, right, in a conductor is given by, right, now here in this case, therefore here in this case DF bar is equals to I into, that is DL bar cross B bar. Force experienced by all the electrons in a DL element is DF. But I want the force experienced by all electrons in a conductor, right? In a small length element, the force experienced by all the electrons is like this. Now throughout the conductor, whatever the number of electrons, the total force experienced by all number of electrons, this can be integrated. Therefore, now this is equals to, what to say, F bar is equals to, what to say, I into DL integration is L bar, that is L bar cross B bar. Now this is the force. Now it has a magnitude. That is magnitude F is equals to, what to say, I into L B, right, sin theta. Therefore, this is the force. Now, here there is a case one. Right, B. Suppose this is the magnetic field. This is the magnetic field. Now, current carrying conductor. This is the current carrying conductor. Now, the current carrying conductor is placed along the magnetic field. Theta is equals to 0, F is equals to I L B, that is theta sin 0, F is equals to I L B sin 0, that implies F is equals to 0. Therefore, the current carrying conductor is placed along the magnetic field. It will not experience any force. Therefore, case 2. Right, now this is a magnetic field, this is the magnetic field, now this is the current carrying conductor, this is the current carrying conductor. What is the current? That is, the current is I, right? Now here the current carrying conductor is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Theta is equals to 90 degrees, therefore F is equals to ILB, that is sine theta. Therefore, F is equals to I L B sin theta, that is sin 90. Therefore, sin 90 is equals to 1. Therefore, F is equals to I L B. Therefore, here there is a minimum force, there is a maximum force. Whenever the current carrying conductor is placed along the magnetic field, it will experience zero force. When the current carrying conductor is placed perpendicular to the magnetic field, it will experience the maximum force. F is equals to I L B. Now, the direction of the force can be explained by Fleming left hand rule. Right, now what is the Fleming left hand rule? Fleming left hand rule gives the direction of the force experienced by the current carrying conductor is placed in the uniform magnetic field, or the moving charge placed in the uniform magnetic field, it will experience a force. That direction of the force can be determined by the Fleming left hand rule. Now, what is the Fleming left hand rule? In the previous topic, a moving charge placed in the uniform magnetic field, it will experience a force. The direction of the force can be determined by the Fleming left hand rule. When a current carrying conductor is placed in the uniform magnetic field, no doubt there is a force. That direction of the force can be determined by Fleming left hand rule. What is the Fleming left hand rule? This is the left hand, that is, these are the three fingers: thumb finger, forefinger, and the middle finger. Thumb finger, middle finger. Now in this case, right here, the current is in the direction of middle finger, and the forefinger is in the direction of magnetic field. Then perpendicular to the both, there is a thumb in the direction of force. Therefore, now what is the magnitude? F bar is equals to Q bar V bar cross B bar. Now here, or otherwise, F bar is equals to I into, that is, what to say, L bar cross B bar. Now here in this case, this is what to say, Fleming left hand rule. Here what to say, forefinger. Next what to say, middle finger. Next thumb finger. Right, in the direction of forefinger, what is there? Magnetic field. In the direction of middle finger, what is there? That is current. Right, in the direction of forefinger, what is there? Magnetic field. In the direction of middle finger, what is there? Current. Right, now this direction shows magnetic field, this will shows the current. What is the plane formed by this? This is the plane formed by this. This is the B, this is I. What is the plane? This is the plane. Perpendicular to the plane, there is a thumb. This thumb shows the direction of the force. Right? By keeping the thumb finger, forefinger, middle finger are mutually perpendicular. If the magnetic field is in the direction of forefinger, the current is in the direction of middle finger, then the force is in the direction of thumb finger. This is called Fleming left hand rule.